How you doing, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to MechWarrior Online with Scout. In today's video, what I want to do is finish up our look at the Centurion chassis that we kind of started with the CN9A, the NCIX variant. And to do that, we're going to be taking a look at this mech right here, the CN9-AL. So let's take a look at this thing's mech summary right quick, and we'll start talking about this just a little bit. So here's the summary for the Centurion 9AL variant, and you can see right away what makes this variant stick out a little bit. It has absolutely zero ballistic hardpoints. Instead, what it has is 4 energy hardpoints, 2 missile hardpoints, and an AMS. Now you can see its quirk summary there on the right. I'm not going to run through all of it, but the bottom line, it doesn't have the raw speed potential of the CN9D, and it doesn't have the turn bonus, acceleration and deceleration bonuses of the CN9A. Similarly, it doesn't have the right arm armor bonuses of those mech. It does have some, but it's not quite as large. What you're getting in exchange for that, though, is the best structure bonuses across the Centurions. They're not the highest, again, because of the right arm between on the CN9A and the D, but overall, across the whole mech, this is, in my opinion, the toughest of the Centurion chassis. In addition, you'll notice you're also getting a energy heat generation bonus of -20%, which is pretty significant. So you're getting a nice quirk to actually use those 4 energy hard points, as well as a laser duration bonus, and an additional large laser cooldown, and then the nice missile velocity and cooldown perks from the CN9A. So if we take a look at this thing in the mech lab, you can see here what I've done with my AL Centurion. Right away, you'll probably notice that I've used every bit of tonnage in this mech, nothing left over, and almost all the hard points. We've only got 2 empty slots. Now, what I would like you to keep in mind when you're taking a look at this build is the 2 things that I did when I was building this mech. The first thing I wanted to do is I wanted to keep the flavor of the Centurion. Yeah, I could just run 3 large lasers or 3 large pulse lasers in this thing, but blah. It doesn't look anything like a Centurion, and I could probably find a 50-ton mech that could do an all-energy loadout better. Crab, I'm looking at you. The other thing I'd ask you to keep in mind is that I always had in the back of my mind that I'm going to end up competing with my Hunchback 4SP because I've got 4 energy hardpoints and 2 missile hardpoints. That sounds a lot like a 4SP, and what I don't want to do is duplicate that build, because if that's what I was going to do, why would I run a Centurion? I could just do it arguably better in a 4SP. So keeping those 2 points in mind, this is the build that I came up with. First thing you do is I upgraded the internal structure to an endosteel skeleton, and then I added on double heat sinks. And what that did is that saved me a lot of weight. It allowed me to throw out the small laser that was in the right arm and replace that with another medium laser. I stripped out the LRM-10 and I replaced it with 2 SRM-6s, and then I added Artemis to those. I have 2.5 tons of ammunition, and then I upgraded the engine to a standard 205 just to get a little bit more speed out of this thing. What I find is that what this build gives me is a mech that's still fairly well-rounded. I can sit at medium range and I can right side peek, get my medium laser in there. If in the game eventually gets into a brawl, which 9 times out of 10 it normally does, then I've got my 3 medium lasers, I still got my large laser, and 2 SRM-6s with Artemis. Like, I actually have a viable knockout punch now. And as you can see down here in the stats, with a heat management of 1.23, it doesn't really kill you to fire the large, the mediums, and the SRM-6s. You can do that about twice, and start even really in on a third run before you really start to get hot. So that kind of well-roundedness without losing a knockout punch is what really, really appeals to me about this mech. The play style in this thing obviously is really easy. Be patient, right side peek, get some free damage in with a large laser where you can, stick with your heavies, protect them from the lights, and when the brawl kicks off, you follow them in and really amplify your damage with all of your lasers and your SRM-6s. Now, in terms of modules, like I alluded to earlier, I do not live or die by the large laser. The large laser is just something that's nice to have. I do, however, live or die by my medium lasers and my SRM-6s, my ability to put a mech down in a fight. So the modules that I go with are obviously radar deprivation, and then I actually choose a medium laser cooldown and an SRM-6 cooldown in order to improve my DPS that little bit. And that's pretty much it for the build, folks. Pretty simple, and again, that's what I like about it. It's easy to use, and I think you'll find that you will get good results with it, and it's a good looking mech. Again, I've got it done up in Steiner paint colors here, just because I think it looks cool. Plus, I've got a Davian one, so why not have a House Steiner one as well? So let's take a look at the gameplay, and I'll show you guys this thing in action.
This is Command. Eliminate all enemies, online. No matter the cost.
Sensors online. Weapons online. All
systems nominal. So, it occurs to me that I have completely failed to give you guys any Centurion lore in the previous two Centurion videos. How about that? Look at that ugly dude. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to try to cover it all here. There's a lot to cover though, actually. Centurion has a pretty interesting history, so if I get interrupted, I'll try to make note of where I left off and we'll continue it in the next one. Anyway, the Centurion is actually manufactured by Korean Enterprises, C, not a K, and it actually started production in 2801, so it's a pretty old mech. Korean Enterprises, by the way, the same company that built the Trebuchet. The Centurion was designed to be a companion mech to the Trebuchet. It would contribute to the Trebuchet's fire support with its LRM-10, but the Trebuchet was especially vulnerable if anybody closed with it. So the idea was, when that happened and the opponent closed with the Trebuchet, the Centurion would step up with this big bad AC-10. It's a pretty potent weapon for a 50-ton mech at the time, and it didn't generate heat, so you could keep opening up with it. And it would step up and it would protect the Trebuchet. So the two were supposed to work really well together. And at least according to the lore, they actually did. It was a pretty popular mech, pretty popular combination. It was very successful, despite the fact it did have some drawbacks. And what do you know? It looks like I'm going to get interrupted. We'll just try to snipe here with our large laser. Don't want to overcommit. Drawbacks to the Centurion, first and foremost, obviously it was ammunition dependent. AC-10 and LRM-10, it had to carry ammunition for both heavy systems. There's more lights over there. Let the team know. And I guess we'll have to come back to the lore, because I'm actually going to... I don't like to fight lights in this thing. I wish it was a little bit faster, but I think that's part of our job. So, as a 50-ton medium mech and in this thing. So we're going to go back here and try to deal with these light mechs. Hello! Didn't expect him there. Miss Lynx pops right out in front of us. Oh man, we're tearing him up though. If he's going to keep running in straight lines like that. I don't mind dealing with light mechs when they do that. He's still here. Low signal strength. Oh, where'd he go? There he is. Hello. Ooh, I bet that hurt. Oh. Yeah. Target destroyed. We will take that. Ouch. What was that? New target. What was that? Where's it at? Oh, it's a Jenner. Ooh. Oh, that's a pretty good result for the team. There's two lights down already. Peek around here. Nope. Got pegged a little bit. And you saw how devastating those SRMs can be, though. If those light mechs run in a straight line for you, you can actually deal with them pretty effectively in this thing because of the Artemis guidance systems on the SRM-6s. We're going to keep working our way up here. We're a little bit too far back, really, for the large laser, even though I keep trying it. You never know your luck. You might get a couple of points of damage, but I'm going to go up here by this ramp. Thought I saw somebody out here. See what we can get. Yep, there he is. That's a Huntsman. Nope, too far for mediums. Ooh, look at all those medium pulse lasers. We're going to stop right here and just keep working them with the large laser. Not going to get any closer to that. Doesn't look like he wants to come to us though, and actually we've been left by the team, so I'm so busy talking and chasing lights I'm about to get left. Let's see if we can catch up to him. Again, the nice thing about going to a bigger engine, even though some people might prefer having more ammunition, is I'm a little bit faster than your standard Centurion. Not much, but a little bit. So I should be able to catch up, and it looks like the fight's happening right there in front of us, so we don't have far to go. This stalker probably needs to move the F out. Standing alone by yourself like that. If there are any lights left, he's food for him. That Huntsman might come over here and get him. And look at that, he got tangled up on something. Didn't even see what that was. Acquired. Looks like we got a fight going down here. There's some big mechs stomping around in here. Have to be careful. We want to try to get an angle on somebody. I don't want to pull right out in front of a... I don't know, Kodiak or something horrible like that. Guys over here on the right. Ow. Look at that. That's I can't tell what it is. It's probably a Kodiak, I'm thinking. Maybe a Nightjar. I think a Nightjar has high ballistic mounts. Something. Whatever it was wailing on us. Let's, here we go. Look at this guy's heads back to us. Take that. Oh, don't turn around. That's fine. Oh, Jesus. Oh, look out, look out, look out, look out. Oh, thank God. We're just gonna wail him right in the back. Hit our coolant flush so we can keep wailing on him. Come on, and he goes down. Ooh, there's that huntsman. Come on. Yeah. Whew, that could have been ugly. He was already beat up, though. If he was fresh, that, oh, come on, get out of the way. If he was fresh, that could have been ugly. Got hung up there on our van, but some big mechs coming out here. Well, bigger than us, anyway. Ow! Surprise! Actually, I think that dragon came off worse for wear. Let's go after him. He's, turn tight, 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 tight. We're gonna try to cut him off right here on this road to the left. Hi! Oh, he just went right past us. Oh, I missed. That was a terrible shot. And we got him anyway. And can we get a piece of this last guy? Come on, turn! Not the most nimble thing in the world. Let's go around the left. Take that. Man, just like that, that's over, man. That was pretty exciting, bro. Got interesting when those two big guys came stomping out around the corner. I thought we might be in a lot of trouble. Fortunately, they ignored us, and that tends to happen to you a lot in this Centurion. But as you can see there, 493, just shy of 500 points of damage, 3 kills, 4 assists, 1 kill most damage dealt. Pretty respectable in a 50-ton mech, especially one that's not really a meta mech. So I'm pretty happy with that result. Look at it. According to the team, that's pretty competitive. So, not too shabby for our first game in the Centurion AL. Let's see if we can get another one.
This is Command. Eliminate all enemies, no matter the cost.
Sensors online. Weapons online. All systems nominal.
So, picking up where we left off after that first game on the background of a Centurion, drawbacks. It was pretty ammunition dependent, and because of that, because it's mounted an AC-10 and an LRM-10 and all the ammunition for it, it was also actually a little bit light on armor. And when that combined with kind of the other drawback, it's not really a drawback of the Centurion, but according to the lore, pilots felt overconfident because they had an AC-10 and a 50-ton mech, which is not all that common outside of the Hunchbacks. And so they get themselves into fights that they really could not win. And then again, another lore thing, not really a mech thing. There was a problem with the loading mechanism in the AC-10. It did not always load reliably. And so that kind of, you can see how that would exacerbate the other issues with the Centurion. But despite all that, it was pretty popular. It was very popular, actually, in House Davian. And it almost became the mech of the medium mech of choice for the armed forces of the Federated Suns, but then the Enforcer came along. And then some other problems happened that kind of relegated the Centurion to the back seat, if you will. It was really the loading mechanisms that really got it a bad rap, which the Enforcer did not have. But then in 2845, the main line of production for the Centurion on Raman 2 was destroyed. And since the Armed Forces of the Federated Suns were already looking at going to the Enforcer, the future for the Centurion got really, really shaky. Some things were done to try to prop it up while it got a new lineup. They went to probably the CN9-AH was probably the first variant where they tried to introduce the AC-20, but it wasn't really popular outside of the very niche role, storming parties and things like that. And then the other major variant was the one we're playing right now, the AL, where they pulled out the autocannon entirely, went to a large and small laser, added some heat sinks, and most importantly, added 2 tons of armor. And that variant was very popular, is especially popular in Steiner space. The Lyran Alliance really liked to use it as a guerrilla mech. And it's kind of what we're doing here, just peeking, trying to get some free large laser damage. Looks like we got some guys off to the right. We'll stomp over here this way and see what we can find. And we'll pick up our lore on the Centurion. We'll close it out, hopefully, in the next one. But yeah, in the beginning of the 31st century, things were not looking all that great for the Centurion. It was actually, you know, outside of the ALs that remained in Liren space, it was actually about to be replaced by the Enforcer. And where'd that guy go? Did I lose him while I was running my mouth? I thought he was right out here somewhere. We got a heavy with us, so we'll keep looking. Oh, there he is. Looks like he doubled back in.
Target acquired.
Oh, can't mark him.
Target destroyed.
And well, we could go up here, because we can right arm peek around this thing right here and get some large laser damage in, as long as we're careful.
Target acquired.
Don't want to overcommit, though. Hi. Boom. Yeah, that made him unhappy, and there he goes. And then we'll get some peeks in on this Timberwolf. Oh, I'm surprised it was hit. I thought I could break lock, but I think I just didn't back up fast enough. I was busy trying to mark him. And oh, here's another victim. Hi. Oh, that shadow cat, poor guy. He's probably trying to back out of the way and back right in front of our SRMs. Not good for him. Fortunate for us, though. Now we're going to try to close up and progress this fight. And oh, that guy just met a bad end. That shadow cat scared me. I almost shot him. What do we got here? Are they up? Yeah, it looks like the majority of them are up there. We're going to close on them. Get some free large laser. Alright, if you're just going to stand there now, I was going to ignore you. Take that. Oh, please run in a straight line. Please move, 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 move. I think everybody loves obliterating locusts. It's just such a pain. This is good. We got a heavy and a salt with us, so we'll push right on up this hill. Hopefully they come with us. Let's see what we got target up here.
Let's
see if we can get some shots here. Oh, that's more people than I expected. Let's back up. Back up, back up, back up. We're getting tagged by LRMs. No, 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 no. Do not want able to get around those. Okay, the assault and the heavy route. We got to get back up the hill and support them. Now that they're up there, it should be a little easier. Oh, hello. There's another Centurion. And there's my phone going off in the background. Die. What's this now? Another locust. Go away. Let's see if we can get another piece of this Centurion. No, he's backing off. No, 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 no. Do not want. Wow, a lot of those went to my left leg. I was trying to catch them on the left arm. Obviously, this Centurion, like the others, if you're going to catch something, if you have to, you want to catch it in the left arm.
New target.
Don't really want to give away the left torso, though, if you can help it. Those twin SRM-6s are pretty punchy. Oh, there's this guy again. He just glitched. Did you see that? Go down here and see if we can get a piece of this Warhawk. Hello! Oh, give us the back. Yes! We will take that. Where's this guy going? Hi.
New target.
Take it. Take it.
New target acquired.
Let's see if we can get back up here. I want that Centurion. Yeah, there he is.
Target destroyed.
Ah, they got him. What's left? Shadow Cat, I think?
Target
or is it
acquired.
That Pirate's Bane? Yeah, way out there. Might be able to head him off. Can we? Yeah, we got a piece of them. Not as good as we like, but we got some good hits there. Maybe again? Aw. I didn't see that ridge there. This is worth a shot. Oh, stuck on terrain. And that's a game. I feel like that was a pretty good game. It wasn't quite as brawly as I expected. I thought at first it was going to be a big brawl, and then it was like it stopped at like 300 meters, but yeah, that's not too bad. 523 points of damage, another 3 kills, 6 assists this time. Not too shabby. We also got, you saw, 2 solo kills and 2 kills most damage dealt, so I feel like this was a little more successful than last game, and as you can see by the scores, we're pretty competitive with the rest of the team still, so it's kind of an odd-paced game, kind of 2 fights instead of 1, but I'm pretty happy with that, and I think the mech did pretty well, so let's see if we can get one more good one in.
Good evening. This is Command. Eliminate all enemies, no matter the cost.
Sensors online. Weapons online. All systems nominal.
All right, let's see if we can close out Centurion lore before this kicks off. So we left off in the 31st century, and the Centurion was not in a good place. It was about to be replaced, actually, by the Enforcer. But then a couple of things happened that actually breathed new life into the Centurion. First is the rediscovery of all the lost technology, double heat sinks, Albion XL cannons, XL engines, etc. All that stuff is starting to come out. And Korean Enterprises is finally setting up a new line to manufacture the Centurions. And the other thing that really helps out the Centurion is the merger of the Lyran Commonwealth and the Federated Suns into the Federated Commonwealth. Now, when this happens, their two militaries are joined as well. And so they decide that they need to do something with all these Centurions that the Lyrans have, because the Lyrans aren't going to get rid of them. And so research starts, Korean Enterprises starts setting up a new line, and the new Avalon Institute of Science, NAIS, jumps on board, and they're like, well, if we're going to have Centurions in this new joint military, they may as well not suck. So they pitch in, and the end result of all that research and development is the CN9-D Centurion. So there you go. That's kind of the history of the Centurion from 2801 with the CN9-A all the way up to 3050 with the CN9-D. And we are going to get up here and peek in the middle and see if we can't find something here. Kind of surprised that no one's here, actually. And hell, that scared me. Hunchback coming out. I almost shot you. I thought that's who was shooting across there. Got a little bit of burn on that guy as he went from right to left in front of us, but it looks like they're playing pretty passively, all packed down into that corner over there. Somebody's over there, got left alone. We got a guy on them, so we're going to move this direction here. We'll either get into that fight back there, or actually, that guy's probably going to kill him before we get there, so we'll just come on around. You notice we got somebody with us off to our right, and that guy that was infiltrating the back should be coming back this way, so I don't feel like we're taking too big of a risk trying to open up a flank here. This is kind of the downside to playing in the murder ball, if you will. If you don't actually push somewhere, your murder ball just becomes a ball of death as you get surrounded. So that's what we're going to try to do to him here. We peek the right arm around. He's not looking at us, so we go out and get some SRM shots too. He didn't even look. We'll peek back out again. Hi. And he's just running, trying to get to cover. Don't see anybody, so we'll move up. We'll just peek right over here. We know they're here. Yeah, there's that guy. New target. Okay. Don't want to go down there. That's going to be where there's somebody else. He's not looking either, so we'll take some shots at him. Hi. You can see the fire going back and forth, so it would be foolish to go down there. But we can still make them look at us. Get as much kind of free shots as we can. Looks like they're backing up, so you know what? We're going to reposition. We're going to go further off. To, well, I guess it's both their left, and when we turn around, our left. Here we go. Again, we're not going to push this too hard. We just want to make people look in our direction while hopefully our assaults and heavies are pushing from our left. No, Stalker, do not want. He's an LRM Stalker. We could probably take him, but not if that Timberwolf also takes an interest and then somebody else. So we'll just stick with our target here. Use the coolant flush. Nope, 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 nope. You see we're attracting some attention from the rest of the team. We want to be a thorn in their side, but we don't want to get everyone's attention. Ah, get out of the way, bud. Look out, look out, look out, look out. Getting hung up. Oh, God. Stalker. Put some SRMs in his face here. Ah, yep, there's someone else coming. Back off, back off, back off, back off. Oh, hello. We're going to give him our right side. We're going to advance on this guy. We don't want him to have any success, because then friends may come with him. So we're gonna jump on this guy. Come on, give me the kill. Come on. No, we did not get the kill, but we did a lot of damage. Ow, we're just gonna keep moving here, give him our shield arm, get back around to cover, and then poke up on this ramp here, whoever this is. Hi. Glad to meet you. No. He's got ailerons. We're just going to tank him. We're going to keep backing up and pull him out in front of those guys that were off to our left and behind us. Maybe we can get a kill out of this. Come on, give me a kill. No. We didn't get a kill, but we tried. Man, that was over quick. I feel like we did alright for ourselves, though, even though it was a quick game. Yeah, 658 points of damage and 2 kills most damage dealt. I'm pretty happy with that. I feel like we did a good amount of work in that game. And if we take a look at the team score, yeah, we're pretty competitive with everybody else. So even though we didn't get any kills, I think that's a really good game. I think it also shows you how much success you can have with the Centurion when you play within the limits of the build. You know, stick to some heavies and assaults. Don't try to go up there and push into their heavy assaults, but just work your corners, work with your teammates, and you can really have a lot of success in this Centurion. So there you have it, folks. 3 what I think are pretty decent games in a non-meta Centurion, and not too shabby, if I do say so myself. Hopefully what I've been able to show you guys is that this build is really quite viable. It's very flexible, it's easy to play, and it's fairly easy to do well with it as long as you play it in the role that it was designed to build. And in point of fact, if you're one of the newer players to Mech Warrior Online, this is a mech that I would definitely recommend for you as a way to break your way into the game and learn the ins and outs of Mech Warrior Online. As a matter of fact, if you are absolutely convinced that you want to go the Centurion route instead of the Hunchback route to kind of learn the game, you could definitely do worse than starting with a CN9-AL Centurion, this mech right here, learning how to play on this, then going to the CN9-A, which will be a similar playstyle for you, but a little bit different. It will teach you about ballistics and right arm ballistics and convergence and all those things. And then wrapping up, taking everything you've learned from the AL and from the A, and then applying it to the CN9-D, which I think has the most potential of the 3 Centurions, but it's definitely the least forgiving, because in order to make the most of it, you really need to have that XL engine. So you're going to have to apply everything that you learned from the previous 2 mechs and all the positioning and play experience that you've got in order the CN9D to perform to its fullest potential. So as you can see, I think they make a really nice set of mechs for folks that are coming into the game as a way to learn pretty much all the basics, the fundamentals that you need to know in order to be successful at Mech Warrior Online. So having said that, folks, I'm going to call this video a wrap. If you have any questions or any comments, please feel free to leave them in the section down below. As always, I love hearing from you guys. Thanks so much for watching this video. Hope you've enjoyed it. Hope you found the Centurion series useful. Stay tuned. There's a lot more to come. Probably a Jaeger Mech video coming very soon. A Cataphract video for the House Lao folks. And this has actually got me enjoying my 50-ton mechs again, so there's probably going to be a Hunchback series of videos coming soon, not only featuring the Hunchback, but also as a great first mech for new players. So lots more to come here on the channel. Thank you guys so much. We'll see you next time.